Hello there. How is everyone doing today on this Good Friday? It snowed a lot here, as we told you Wednesday night, but now the sun is shining and the snow is melting. Hey, hubby. Hey, Rebecca. Welcome. Hey, Dana. So glad you guys are here. Hope that you're having a great day. Hey, Tara. Welcome. Authentic Life 45. Please remind me of your name. Joyfi Thrifty, welcome. Please remind me of your name too. It's been a while, and I want to make sure I call you by name because Jesus called each of us by name, doesn't he? All right, this is KDM Reed from KDMReed.com. How are you doing today, Stephanie? Thank you. Thank you for grace. I hope you guys are all doing great today. Thank you for joining me on this edition of We Write. So you can see the sun streaming in. The sun does come out in Michigan, so that is a very good thing. Hey, just a public service announcement for those of you. I know I've said this Monday and I said this Wednesday, and hopefully this will be the last time that I have to say it, but if you cannot comment on this, yes, thank you, hubby. If you cannot comment on my scope, it's probably because you have naked people following you. And I really don't want to see that. And so I choose to follow people back where their followers aren't a bunch of naked people. And yes, Jesus does love naked people, but because we live in a sinful world and we are not in the garden anymore, I'd rather see people clothed, except, hubby. But that's another story. That's for another scope, right? So anyway, so if that might be why, because I have to follow you back for you to be able to comment. And so we want to keep the comments friendly here, and we want to make sure everyone feels safe and isn't being harassed and all that kind of stuff. So that's why I choose to do that. And anyway, so there you go. But what I want to talk to you today is about kind of a dreaded word called platform. Hey, Debbie, welcome. Do you have school off today, Debbie? Are you guys off for Good Friday? I think if we're friends on Facebook, then you saw that our the churches in our area do a Good Friday service, a community service, and it's just my favorite because it's all these different congregation that don't necessarily agree on all the issues, but they get together and they worship the Lord and thank Him for what He has done by dying on the cross for us, and that is tonight, and I'm so excited about that because it's just a picture of what heaven will be like. Every tribe, tongue, and nation. We don't have every tribe, tongue, and nation, that's a tongue twister, represented there, but it's just a very special time. Oh, bless you, Debbie. I hope that you are recovering well. And yes, I hope that you're recovering well and that you're resting in Him. See what I did there? So anyway, but yesterday I was just having a hard day, and I still kind of am today, but I'm trying to snap out of it. Oh, neat, Tara. That is very neat. But it's well, have a safe trip. Are you flying or driving? But anyway, so the dreaded word platform, and a lot of times it's hard to get published unless you have, well, drive safe, Debbie. A lot of times it's hard to get published if you don't have a significant platform, which that just means you probably know a lot of people, a significant amount of people following you or subscribing to your blog. And it can be frustrating because sometimes you're just like, can't you just like my writing and want to publish me because of that? But I understand that publishing houses are businesses and they do need to be able to pay their employees. And so that they're always constantly losing money because people don't have a big enough reach for the books, then I see where they're coming from. However, it can really mess with us as Christians. And we've talked about this somewhat. But what I'm talking about today is there's a lady named Farine, and she is 80 years old. And she has an awesome awesome story and book to share. But guess what? There's an agent interested in her, but the agent can't pick her up and she probably can't get published unless she has a platform. Well, can you imagine being 80 and trying to figure out all these ins and outs of building a platform? Ick, right? Ain't nobody got time for that. So my friend Jamie Amarine has graciously made an author page for Farine, and we're trying to get her to have 5,000 likes. And if she has 5,000 likes, she will probably be able to get picked up by an agent and maybe even get published. So if you are on my Instagram today, Katie_M_Reed, the same goes for Twitter or on Facebook, you can find the link to read about Farine's story, which will just bless your socks off. And then there's a link to like her page. Will you guys also do me a favor? If you not only like it, but you share the post and then invite all your friends to like the page. I mean, some of your friends might be annoyed, but you know what? This is a really important thing. And you know what I would love? This is my secret, not so secret now prayer, is that she can get like 10,000 likes. Wouldn't that be awesome to kind of just say, hey, look, publishing world, we can band together and make this happen. Because her Farine story needs to be told. It's about the good and the hard and how God is with us in the midst of it. And I know you'll just fall in love with her. So please check that out on my different social media things today and share it. And thank you in advance for doing that. You know, it was one of those things where it's like, you know, platform can be such a dread, but it's like we can all band together and help make this happen with the Lord's help. So will you do that for me, friends? I would be so grateful. So I'm going to give a little message here today, and I hope that's okay, because I sometimes, you know, you need to, hey, Jessica, welcome. You need to like give yourself a pep talk, right? I give lots of other people a pep talk, but sometimes I need to give myself a pep talk. And so I hope this is giving you a pep talk as well. But here it goes. Okay. So, you know, the crowds matter to Jesus. You know, sometimes I think we're like with all this, and this is in regards to platform. All right. You know, the crowds did matter to Jesus, but guess what? So did the one. You know, it says he would leave his 99 sheep to go get the lost one. So it's like one matters and the crowds also matter. Jesus used a platform. Guess what he used it for? He used it to die upon, for his flesh to die for the love of each of us. My friend Chris Camille, I've shared this before, but she talks about how God wants us to build altars instead of platforms so that we can pour ourselves out. We can die to ourselves and we can show love to other people. Numbers matter to God. He fed the 5,000, right? Yet he entrusted the spreading of the word and the building of the church to a small group of disciples. He built part of the church, right? But yet he entrusted others to go and do that. It wasn't all about him. He was it is all about him, but I think you know what I mean. He took a risk and let others spread the message. And what matters is the heart. You know, it can be great if our posts go viral. I mean, how exciting. But what's beautiful is that when that happens, but we also have a pure heart. My friend Christy Mobley was on foreverymom.com yesterday with this great post called For the Least of These. And you should read it if you have not. And I messaged Christy and I said, Christy, I know numbers aren't everything. I know success is more about the heart than it is about numbers. But what joy I have for you, friend, when I see the heart and the numbers blended together. And it was such a joy to see that. You know, the small things, we've talked about this before, can really be the big things after all. And I wanted to read you guys just an excerpt from a post that talks about how really small is the new big. So let's head on over to the computer here because I've got to read it. Sorry, the lighting's going to be kind of weird. It's going to look like I just got resurrected. But this is from a post I wrote on God-Sized Dreams called When Your Dreams Feel Small and Ordinary. And we talked on Monday about my brother who has Down syndrome for World Down Syndrome Day. And this is a little bit about him. So it says, Brian is an example of someone who lives a small life in the world's eyes. He has Down syndrome and his dreams of marriage, having children, and playing football at Notre Dame remain unfulfilled. Yet he lives life large as he quietly goes about his daily business. He brings us joy by offering an arm around the shoulder on a hard day, selecting the perfect birthday card to lift spirits, and making us laugh as he piles clothes, and sometimes underwear, atop his head for comic relief. My brother's simple life makes a big difference to those around him. My blog is katiemreed.com, and someone could type it out for you, Jessica, but this is actually from godsizeddreams.com, a post that I wrote. But God chooses the foolish things of the world to shame the wise. God chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. 1 Corinthians 1:27. Several years ago, I watched a televised event in which a well-known talk show host received gushing accolades as she retired from her current position. There were speeches, glitz, and lots of gratitude poured out as a woman was elevated higher than the dome's arched ceiling. As I watched this celebration unfold, I couldn't help but think, wow, she's sure getting praised, almost worshiped from the masses for her successes. And I wonder if we have it all wrong. Maybe at the end of this journey, God is going to throw confetti all over the ones who faithfully lived out their small and ordinary lives. Like my friend and my brother, their dreams may not have changed the world, but they affected one life at a time, steadily and humbly, and that made all the difference. We often receive earthly praise for pursuing big dreams, but being faithful with the small things is often harder, and I think even more important in the end. And I don't know about you, but I needed that reminder. I know I get, just caught in this comparison trap. I've been discouraged about my memoir, which is funny because 2 days ago I was feeling really good. Like, I am so thankful for all this feedback I got from my peers. And then yesterday I'm like, oh, this feedback makes me feel like I'm awful, even though I know their hearts to help me. So I was just ping-ponging around. So, I get discouraged when I compare. When I tune in to the static of the inner critic, you know, anyone have that inner critic? Sometimes called the enemy, sometimes called the flesh. And then when I'm checking my stats, I get discouraged. But then I was thinking, you know what? Jesus' love is beyond compare. His truth clears the static. When we go to his word, it clears our mind as we tune into what he's really saying about us. And the last time I checked my status, guess what? It said priceless worth. And I'm in good standing. You know why? Because I'm standing under the shadow of my Savior's wings. And I am in good standing because of what he has accomplished. And isn't that today what we're celebrating? You know, and a lot of people are like, oh, this was like the worst day and in history. And it's like, yes, but I have so much joy. I refuse to wear black today. I should have gotten brighter, but just like at my funeral, you'll read in my book, it's like, please don't wear black. So it's the same thing of like, I know had we been there and not known the end of the story, it would have been awful, but we already know Sunday's coming. There's this great video called Sunday is a coming. You got to watch it. Just look, you know, type it in like that. Sunday is a coming. But anyway, it gets me pumped up. We watched it at the Good Friday service last year, but we can celebrate. Yes, it's humbling that someone had to die, a sinless, perfect lamb on our behalf. But we can celebrate because he did it for love. He did it for us. He got on that platform and died so that we could live. And he died for each and every number, every person that's ever lived and is going to live. And so I hope that encourages you today. And yes, Debbie, I saw your message. You will learn more. And I remember one thing they did say at that Speak Up, that, or actually it was at She Speaks, but I thought it was helpful. It's like, you know, sometimes we get weird about the numbers, but if God's put a burning message on our heart, wouldn't we want the most people to hear it as possible? And I say yes and amen, but guess what? Sometimes that message is for a small group, and that small, they're not any less important than the masses. And so it's all about balance, isn't it? But I hope you're encouraged today. And as I see your hearts going up, I am just praying for all our hearts to be faithful with the course set before us. I know I say that a lot, to not to look to the right and to the left, and to know we are loved. You have priceless worth. If If he is your Savior, if Jesus of Nazareth is your Savior, you are in right standing. Your stats look good, my friend. So I hope that encourages you on this Good Friday. I'll be back here Monday at 1:30 for the Monday message. This is Katie M. Reed from katiemreed.com. I am so blessed that you joined me today, and I just hope that you have a wonderful, wonderful Easter weekend. Talk to you later.